The meaning of Kuja and Njoo. Hello, welcome again to Swahili session, where in today's video we will be learning about the meaning of the word Kuja and Njoo. These two words are confusing to some people, but when one understands the meaning of each word, then speaking Swahili will be easier. You are all welcome. Kuja is a verb which means to come. Kuja is to come. Kuja can be used in all tenses. It can be present, past, future, immediate present, conditional, and habitual. Kuja is a monosyllabic verb, and when one wants to change the meaning or the tense of a sentence with kuja, a prefix is inserted and not an infix nor suffix in the verb kuja. Some people command saying kujeni to mean come in plural, like telling more than one person to come. Kujeni is not grammatically correct. You can confirm it by the suffix it has, eni. We know that this kuja does not have a suffix. When you change it, you can just add a prefix. Kuja in tenses. Present tense, you can say ninakuja, meaning I am coming. The present immediate tense is nimekuja, and it means I have come. The past tense is nilikuja, I came. So we are seeing here what is added is just the prefix nina, kuja, nime, kuja, and nili, kuja. The future tense is nitakuja, meaning I will come. Habitual tense is huja, I come. I always come. Huja, mara kwa mara. Conditional tenses, ningekuja, I would come. Ningalikuja, I would have come. One cannot use kuja as a command word. This is a verb. Njoo. Njoo is not a verb. Njoo is a Swahili command word. Most of the time, njoo is a command given in the present. Despite the fact that the command can be given in the present, but it can be addressing the action to be done in the future. But the word itself cannot be changed to stand alone as a future or past of any Swahili tense. Now we can see njoo in tenses. Njoo means come. Njooni is come or for plural, like you are telling more than one person to come. Njoo hapa means come here. Njoo sasa hivi, come right now. And njoo baadaye is come later, while njoo kesho is come tomorrow. You can also say njoo mwakani or come next year in English. The common practice here about the tenses in njoo here in Tanzania is to use njoo as a command and not a word. You cannot add suffix, for example, for the past tense. You cannot say nilinjoo to mean you came, but you can say nilikuja, I came. In the future tense, you cannot say nitanjoo, you'll say nitakuja. One cannot command by using the word kuja, despite the power of influence one has. And this is the end of today's Swahili session about the verb kuja and the commanding word njoo. For more understanding of this topic, you may click a card at the end of this video where you will be directed to the topic which says differences between kuja, njoo, kwenda and nenda. See you next time. Thank you.